Hey everyone, I'm Ekadas Thana, and today I'll be talking about how you can use C++ and Visual Studio to target Windows, iOS, and Android mobile platforms. So let's get started. So starting with Visual Studio 2015 RTM, we introduced the capability for a C++ developer to use one single IDE to target all mobile platforms, whether you're targeting Android, iOS, Windows, or so on. As you're going about this experience using our cross-platform tools, you will be able to use a rich feature set. You can share and reuse your cross-platform code easily. You can use state-of-the-art code editing features like refactoring, IntelliSense across these different platforms. You'll be able to use a powerful debugging experience and also be able to use our emulation experience for Android and Windows and quickly emulate your apps without deploying to devices. Lastly, Visual Studio jumpstarts your cross-platform development with providing you a lot of cross-platform templates and samples. So you'll get a head start here if you're using our experience. So this is stuff that's already there in the product today, in the RTM product. And if you want to catch up on more news about what we already provide today, you can catch us on Visual C++ cross-platform page or the Visual C++ blog there. So with that said, I'm going to get into what's new with this Visual Studio update. So we've basically done a lot of work to improve our cross-platform development experience through a variety of feature set. So the first feature set I'm going to show you is basically a set of improvements we've done for Android. So the first thing we're introducing for Android is support for Gradle build system. Gradle is the default Android build system, and now Visual Studio Android developers can also benefit from using Gradle. As you're building your Android C++ application, from time to time there'll be need for you to be able to access an Android library. This could be an R file, this could be a jar file, and Visual Studio will allow you not only to build these files with this new feature that I'm talking about, which is building referencing Android libraries, but you'll also be able to leverage them and use them and package them as a part of your Android application. The last feature that I want to talk about is the support that we introduced for 64-bit Android native development kits. If you're a game developer and you're making these large monolithic C++ applications, you do really need extra memory, extra resources for your compiler and linker tools. And that is what the 64-bit Android NDK allows you to be able to do. With this update now, you'll be able to install the Android NDK and also use it as you build your Android applications. So with that said, I'm actually going to now move over to our iOS targeting experience and get into a feature set that we've introduced for this update as well. So firstly, we've done a lot of bug fixes and a lot of feature work just to improve our edit build debug cycle as you build your C++ iOS application in Visual Studio. One of the features that I want to talk about, which we're introducing with this update, is import from Xcode. As you already know, Xcode is the default IDE for iOS developers. And we make it easier with this feature, import from Xcode, to bring your existing code that's building in Xcode over to Visual Studio. And I'll demo this feature as well. The second thing I want to talk about is, with iOS 8, developers are now allowed to be able to use frameworks and dynamic libraries and so on. And when you're using Visual Studio, you can still leverage these and reference frameworks and devops easily. Another thing that we've done is that we've actually improved a story for dynamic device population. So when you're connecting the device that's paired to your PC machine for building your iOS app in Visual Studio, you can easily remove it, add it, look into the simulators, and we've basically improved that experience. The last feature that I'm going to talk about in our iOS development story is really open in Xcode. So while we're offering you a great edit build debug cycle for your building your iOS application in Visual Studio, there are still scenarios that you might want to use Xcode for. For example, if you're doing UI changes or you're storyboarding, you probably want to use Xcode for that. Some other experiences, for example, using some Xcode instruments, you probably want to use Xcode for that. So don't worry, we actually still allow you, to be able to open up your existing Visual Studio iOS application in Xcode, be able to do modifications to your project, for example, storyboarding or use Xcode instruments, and then come back to Visual Studio and import back those changes. And that's really what this last feature that we're introducing called Open in Xcode is all about. So that's really what we're offering, overall in this update for cross-platform developers. With that said, I'm going to get into my first demo. I have a couple of demos here, and the first demo is really about building your Android application with Gradle. So I'm just going to get started with that. So here's my Visual Studio 2015 Update 2. If you'll notice in the File New Project cross-platform Android section, you'll see a variety of templates that we've introduced for Gradle support. So I'm actually just going to go ahead and, you know, create a sample from this template and call it Android application. So here's my Visual Studio instance. I'm actually going to go into the File New Project menu. Under the cross-platform Android section, you'll see a variety of templates that we introduced for Gradle. The first template that we have here is the basic application Android Gradle template, and this builds you an end-to-end Android application with the Gradle build system. Another template that we have here is the basic library template, and this will allow you to build an Android library, such as an R file, which you can also then reference into your end-to-end Android application. So let's actually go ahead and, you know, start using the basic application template here. I'm going to call this Android application with Gradle and click OK. This will go ahead and create an Android application. It's a Hello World style project here. And what I want to show you here is that, you know, the first thing you can actually do is you can actually go ahead and install the Java language support here. This is a preview extension that we have, which will give you an improved editing experience for Java. Now, with that said, you know, using Gradle is really simple. We've already taken the work to look at the property pages here in the Gradle section, if you notice. And you can actually go and change some important characteristics about your project here, for example, the APK file name, Android app lib name, and so on, easily. Once you've done that, all you really need to do to leverage this experience is just to build. And if you notice in the output window, this is actually going to go ahead and start using your Gradle build system to be able to build it. It just takes a minute to start up here. There we go. So that's basically, you know, using Gradle, and that's actually built in an Android app. This is an app you can now build and debug. The second demo that I want to show you guys, I'm going to go back to presenting my slides here. So the second demo, so that's really the first demo here, and it just kind of shows you how to use Gradle in VS for developing an Android app. The second demo that I want to show you is really about importing your existing code from a Mac or a PC, from a Mac into Visual Studio. And for that, you know, you can use the import from Xcode experience that I was just talking about earlier. So let's get started on that one now. So here's my Visual Studio instance again. I'm going to go ahead and close this solution. To open the import from Xcode experience, you can look under the File New Import, Import from Xcode option. Once you hit that, Project Wizard, this Project Wizard would come up. And the first thing you do is really that you choose your Xcode project that you want to bring over to Visual Studio. Luckily, I already have one on my drive, on my disk here, so I'm just going to browse to it. So I'm going to go ahead and see it, C:\apps. And I'm going to go ahead and say open sample native. And I'm going to go ahead and point to the pbxproj or the Xcode project file here that's coming from your Xcode project. You can click Next here. So once you click Next, what we really do is we're trying to offer you a cross-platform C++ experience. So we give the option to a user to be able to split his C++ code and his Objective-C into different Visual Studio projects. The first thing you're looking to look at is really the targets, the Xcode targets you can import into Visual Studio here. Sample native, sample native test, native lib test, these are all Xcode targets that you can open into import into Visual Studio. And these will really become Visual Studio projects. The next thing I want to show you is basically the library target section here. So the destination target is really about your, you know, Objective-C, storyboarding, like kind of like projects. The library targets are really for your static libraries that you're building, which are being referenced in your Xcode application. So in this particular case, I have a very simple native library. It's got really two source C++ source files, and that's what really the wizard is telling you. The next thing you can actually go ahead, if you're actually using frameworks, is define a framework search path. For us to be able to look into for referencing frameworks. And then you can also do that here again in the Frameworks tab, which basically allows you to do that at a project level. The Global Properties section is really global tools option setting, and the Framework section here for that is really about being able to do that at a more local project level. Once you've done all this, all you really need to do is just import. So as you can see, I've actually imported my sample native project that was building on my Xcode right here. And let me just go over this for a second, right? So as you can see, sample native is basically, and you know, it contains all the Objective-C code here and the storyboarding and so on. And this is really referencing a C++ library which is really the other project here known as the native lib project. So that's really your C++ code here in the add.h and add.c files. In this particular case, since I've already paired my machine, all I really need to do is build it, and I can really build this on my Mac right here. So I'm actually going to just go ahead and do that. So I'm actually just going to say rebuild solution. So this will really just go ahead and build my iOS application from Visual Studio on the Mac, and that's what's really happening there. As you can see, the build succeeded. So we imported a project from Xcode. We were able to bring it into Visual Studio. We were able to build it right from the word go. And the next thing I want to show you now is really another experience. So let's say that you're done editing, building, and debugging your basic portion of your code in Visual Studio, and now you want to use Xcode for either storyboarding or some other scenario. And as I mentioned, we allow you to do that as well. So what you can do to enable that feature is you can actually go ahead and go to the sample native section here, right-click, and say remote machine, and say open in Xcode. And what that will do is that will actually open up your Xcode project in Xcode, which is right happening right here. So if you see right here, that's really Xcode opening up the same project here. And when I'm done making changes on this machine, I can then basically come back here to my Visual Studio instance and really say, pull from remote, which is going to pull back all the changes back into Visual Studio. So that's really the two things I wanted to show you here from an iOS perspective, the first one being the ability to be able to import your existing Xcode project, and the latter being able to use the Open in Xcode feature to go to Xcode, make some edits to your storyboarding or Xcode instruments usage, and then come back to Visual Studio. So I'm going to go back to my slides here for a second. So that's really the second demo right here. And lastly, just to end, I just want to say, this is the work that we've done. This is work in progress. Android Story is shaping out great. Our iOS experience is also coming along. Here are some of the resources that we have that you can follow us on offline. One is our cross-platform page that's right here, and the other one is our Visual Studio, Visual C++ blog. You can follow us on both these channels. Thank you.